In this video, I'm going to show you an easy way to build a heatset insert press. If you've ever used a drill press, you'll know that it's an easy way to drill an accurate perpendicular hole. The printed parts are on printables, and I'll put the link below. The tolerances are quite close, so they fit together nice and snugly, so there's no wobble when using it. Assembly is pretty easy. Position the base on the wooden base at one end and screw it down with four screws. Then insert the tube into the base and drill a small hole in the bottom so you can put a screw in just to secure it there. Thread an elastic band through the hole in the iron holder arm, and this will support the arm when it's not in use. Slide the arm onto the pole. And attach the top to the pole, and this is what will secure the elastic band. And add a screw just to make sure it stays on. And of course the screw at the top needs a little hole. And snap in the soldering iron and it's good to go. The trickiest step is the soldering iron holder. As all soldering irons are very different, there's no real one design that will suit all irons. So this is why it's a separate piece that can be screwed on. What I did was measure the profile of the soldering iron with a set of calipers. Then I drew the profile in CAD and did a revolve with it of 240 degrees. That's enough to snap fit the iron in. Then you can screw that onto the sliding arm. Don't print this part in PLA. The soldering irons get quite warm and the plastic can soften and the iron will fall out. So print in PETG or ABS. And on that note, obviously never leave soldering irons turned on and unattended. For the counterweight, this is to hold the arm in position when you're not using it. Originally, I thought I'd use a piece of string and a counterweight to hold the arm up when not in use, but this was just getting a bit complicated really. There's too much friction and the weight and everything. So I just used a couple of rubber bands in the end, and this worked really well. It just basically holds the iron in position when you're not holding it. The printed piece at the top is still designed so it can have a piece of string going through it, or you can just loop a rubber band over it. For the soldering iron tip, you can buy a specialist soldering iron tip for heatset inserts, and I did actually buy one, but I couldn't find a cheap iron that would fit it. So I just used a standard tapered tip, and this works okay. It does occasionally stick to the tip, the insert, but it's pretty easy to nudge off. If you like the video, please like and subscribe.